I've decided to make a fruiting chamber to provide me with a space for ideal conditions for the fruiting of mushrooms of most kinds. When mycelium is ready to fruit, one of the things that it needs is very high humidity and good fresh air exchange and appropriate temperatures for fruiting for that particular kind of mushroom. And so what we're going to do is we're going to take this fairly large storage container that I picked up and we're going to turn it into a fruiting chamber. And the first step is remove the lid. Whoops, I guess I better undo the handle. And I've got to drill a bunch of holes, so I'm going to move it to my shop to do that. All right, we need to drill a couple of different sizes of holes, and the only thing I have available is a 1-inch drill bit. So I put the tub over a piece of wood I have extending out from underneath a workbench, and I'm going to basically drill a series of holes. And I can't hold the camera and work at the same time, so I'll show you the finished product here in a minute. Okay, you can see I've drilled kind of three holes close together, and then I'm going to take a knife and clean that out so I have a cleaner, nicer hole to stuff the polyfill in. Okay, it's not real pretty, but there it is. If you have like a hole saw for cutting a doorknob hole or something like that, you know, about... You want about a 2-inch hole approximately. And then on the sides I've also drilled holes spaced about 6 inches apart and about three inches up from the bottom. And these are 1-inch holes. I've got a little cleaning to do on this, and then I'll do the, you know, I'll match this. I've started, but I haven't finished the holes on this end, and I've got these done. So I'm going to finish up the large holes here, and then we'll show the next step. Okay, I've drilled and cut and cleaned all the holes, and now what we're going to do is fill those holes with polyester filler or polyester batting. And the idea is to fill the lower holes relatively tightly and the upper holes relatively loosely to encourage airflow to come in through the lower holes and rise up and escape out the outer holes. And in theory, it's my understanding this will keep the humidity high while providing a good air exchange, fresh air exchange. So I'm cutting the batting in approximately 2-inch wide strips, and then I'm going to roll it up and stuff it in the holes according to the tightness that I perceive to be the appropriate amount. All right, so I thought I'd show you a little trick I've learned for making poly seals in jars. Basically, I roll it most of the way up, and then I kind of rotate it over and fold the end over before I stuff it into the hole so that what goes inside will be all a single surface. Now, that should make it easy to clean, and it produces a good, you know, smooth surface on the inside. And so I'll do that with the rest of the holes. All right, I finished the side holes, the lower holes. And as you saw, I rolled them fairly tightly and stuffed them in there. They're pretty tight, and they'll allow oxygen in, but they should keep the moisture in as well. I'm going to, for the top holes, I'm going to roll it much more loosely. and stuff it in much more loosely. Again, to encourage air to flow out through the top and in through the bottom, you know, because the that's probably a little bit too thick for these holes. Anyway, I'm gonna kind of need to get in the way to finish this. All right, it took a little playing around to get it to the level of tightness, but I could pretty easily push my finger through these. So although they're filling the holes well, nothing but air is going to get through them. They're loosely packed. And there we have the finished fruiting chamber, ready to put trays or bags or cakes of substrate, myceliated substrate in for fruiting. And I could put perlite in the bottom and add moisture to that, but I think I'm going to try it first just misting the sides periodically, because I'm going to be using trays of substrate, of myceliated substrate to fruit from, and see how that works out. And I'll put the results in a later video.